Hi everyone, today I will demonstrate you how to use OrangeDataMining for image clustering. Let's start. First, we need to choose our datasets. Please use datasets module and choose traffic science dataset. This is images datasets, which includes 70 images of traffic signs. Please connect image module datasets to module image viewer and investigate the images or the traffic signs. This is our images. As you can see, we have here 17 small images. Each image has a label, kind of traffic sign. It can be regulatory, it can be warning or yield. We won't use this label in our clustering, but we will use this labeling to understand, to estimate the quality of the clustering. Okay, are you ready? Amazing. Please connect our datasets to image embedding. The magic starts here. Here we can use deep learning network to transform our images to some very good feature space. Here you can choose a couple of different, you can choose some network. Please use Painter's network. Okay, you need to wait in this step. One minute. Okay, now we have two branches. One for hierarchical clustering and one for k-means. Let's start from the first one. To use hierarchical clustering, we need to calculate the distances between images. So please connect to output of image embedding to input of the module distances. In the module distances, you need to choose metric of distance. As you know, the cosinus metric works well for images. So please choose here cosinus metric. And hierarchical clustering, our main guest for now. Okay, now we need to decide how many clusters we want to find. We don't know, in general, we don't know how many clusters we want to find. Probably two, probably three, probably more. We don't know exactly. Okay, first of all, you can connect to the model distances, the model distance map. And here you can see a hint, probably three clusters is a good idea. You can see it here, 1, 2, 3. So let's try to find three clusters. Okay, I move this vertical line to the left until we get three clusters. And now we can look on our labels. Please see, it's amazing. The first blue cluster C1 include only regulatory images, signs. The second red cluster C2 include only yield signs. And the last one, C3 cluster, green cluster, include only warning signs. Amazing. You can connect hierarchical cluster to scatter plot. And as you can see, there are zero errors for this dataset. Zero errors. Amazing. Okay. Now let us investigate the quality of k-means. For k-means in orange, we want to calculate distances metrics. We need to connect output of image embedding to input of k-means. And now, again, we don't know how clusters want to find. We can try to use silhouette score. And silhouette score advice to us to use two clusters, probably three, probably four, between 2 and 4. We don't know exactly. We can try each one of them. But now we know that three clusters is optimal. And now we connect to output of k-means to input of scatterplot. And as you can see, we have here one error. One yield sign of a blue color is here. So this is the error. And if you want to understand this sign, this is black fox, okay? Please press on image viewer and you will see this is guy is a problematic one. It belongs to green cluster, but his sign is a blue. Well, let's investigate the green cluster signs. The green cluster is a warning cluster. It includes circle or almost circle signs. And this guy, it's also warning cluster, but it has triangle form. And our clustering algorithm made error for this sign. That's all for today. Please, at home, try to use another networks, another metrics, and investigate how hierarchical clustering and k-means behaves in these cases. That's all for today. Thank you.